For H, we'll be discussing hunger, what makes us feel hungry, how it affects our mind and our body, and the devastating statistics of world hunger. Now first, let's talk about the difference between cravings and hunger. Now there is a hunger cycle that you go through. Once all of the food in your stomach has been burned up, then your blood sugar levels and your insulin levels become low. And a hormone is released called ghrelin, and this talks to your hypothalamus. Now the hypothalamus is just the part of the brain that regulates a lot of your bodily functions, including your biological clock. So it makes sense that it also regulates your eating clock. Now once this part of the brain receives that hormone, then a protein called neuropeptide Y is released. Now this protein is what causes the stomach lining to contract, and it gives you that hungry feeling. Now this also affects your blood pressure, your heart rate, and your craving for carbs. So the longer you go hungry, the more that this protein is released, and the more that you will crave those pesky carbs. So don't wait to eat. Now once you do start eating, the fatty tissues in your body release a different hormone called leptin. Now this hormone just lets your body know that you are satisfied and you can stop eating. So neuropeptide Y is no longer released, and a different chemical called propion lanocurtin is now released. Now this chemical is what gives you that full feeling, but this takes time, and that's why they suggest eating slowly so you don't overeat. Now personally, I am a fast eater, so I set aside a specific amount I think will be enough, and I wait before I go up for seconds. Now, demanding that we finish our plates is one of the worst lessons our parents ever taught us. Now, obviously, their intentions were good. It is important to not waste food. However, you can just eat it later, save the leftovers, freeze them, or even give them away. That was hunger, and now for cravings. So it was thought that we craved foods because we needed a particular nutrient that was in that food. However, this has recently been debunked. We are actually just addicted to these foods. Especially for fatty and sugary foods, these foods release opioids. And opioids give you that pleasure feeling, and it's the pleasure that we are actually addicted to and craving. So, next time you're craving that delicious treat, just try to find something fun to do instead. It will give you that pleasure feeling that you're craving, and it will also distract you. Now that we know a little bit more about hunger, let's talk about people that are not eating enough, whether it's because a lack of resources or because of a lack of body image. Most people with an eating disorder don't understand when it becomes a problem or that they have the problem at all. Now there is a difference between malnourished and undernourished. Undernourished is directly related to the amount of food that you're eating. So these people are not getting enough calories for their daily needs. Even if all they're eating is healthy foods, they still may not be getting enough calories. While malnourished is not directly related to the amount, you could be eating more calories than you need, but you're not getting the right amount of nutrients like the vitamins and minerals that our body need to function properly. And although the effects are different for each of these, malnourished or undernourished, it can still be devastating to both the mind and the body. The most common deficiencies are iron, vitamin A, iodine, and zinc. And these affect your brain, eyes, and immune system more than anything else. And here's a list of foods that are rich in these chemicals. You can also see the list down below. Now, store-bought chemicals are not always a great resource because they are not federally regulated and they are not held accountable for their ingredients. So, the best way is the natural way, eating the right foods. The World Food Program estimates that over 1 billion people struggle with hunger, and I'm sure it's grown even worse after COVID hit. Asia and Northern Africa account for 75% of the world's hunger, and only about 8% of that are from disasters. The rest are all just daily environment. Now, women and children are way more likely to struggle with hunger issues related to men. And it's said that one child dies every 6 seconds related to hunger issues. Now, there are food programs and organizations that have made great efforts to fight world hunger. But unfortunately, with the rising food prices, it negates most of these efforts. So if you know of a good organization that gives more than it takes, feel free to provide the link down below. And I hope that you guys are getting enough calories and enough nutrition. And I will see you guys next time. Bye!